A very good afternoon to one and all present here. Today in the departmental webinars series, I, Onnesha Nag, the HOD of BPA Hospital Management Department, in the behalf of Nopani Institute of Management Studies, welcome all the participants for the session, Robotic Surgery, Important Concept of Modern Treatment. Now to introduce the topic to you all, I would like to invite our beloved student, Amisha Ghosh, from Hospital Management second semester. Amisha, please carry on.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Amisha Ghosh from BBA Hospital Management. And today we are going to discuss about robotic surgery, which is an important concept of modern treatment. Robotic surgery is a method that the surgery is done with the help of a very small tools that are fixed to a robotic arm. The surgeon does not physically operate in a robotic surgery, but he controls the movement of the robot arm. The robotic surgery, after of a computer, makes small incisions on the patient body to insert certain instruments. All this is done by the surgeon by controlling the robotic arm in a computerized manner. The instrument inserted is fitted with a small thin tube with an attached camera at the end of it, which is also known as endoscope. This endoscope gives the surgeon a complete inside the patient's body to direct the robotic arm in conducting the surgery. The robotic arm basically mimics the surgeon's hand movement to perform the operation. Robotic surgery is advantageous since it can be performed by making smaller cuts than a normal open surgery. The robotic arm ensures maximum precision and can be free of human error. However, robotic surgery can be more time consuming than a normal one. Setting up the robot prior to the surgery takes up considerable time. This is an upcoming procedure and many hospitals are still adopting this method. My introduction is over and I would like to go on with the speakers. Move on to my webinar to the speakers.
Thank you, Amisha, for this wonderful introduction. Now to carry forward the session, I would like to invite Rohit Raj of Hospital Management second semester to put forward his point of view. Rohit, please. Rohit, can you hear me?
Hello, ma'am. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone present here. Myself, Rohit Raj from BHM second semester. Today, I'm going to present the PPT upon robotic surgery. So here we go. Hello. The topic name robotic surgery itself suggests that the surgery performed with the help of robot. Before going to the brief, we should know something about its history. So in 1985, a robot named Puma 560 was used to place a needle for brain. In 1988, the P robot was developed at Imperial College of London. And in 1992, the robot dog was introduced for the hip replacement. And in 2006, the first unnamed robotic surgery took place in Italy. Now there may come a question that why robot only? Because it is not a proper machine. It just gives the information with its arm. It is more accurate than the human being. Now coming to the next slide. In this, I had discussed about the most advanced surgical robot present in the world, which name is Da Vinci. These are mounted on the three separate robotic arms, which allow surgeon to perform maximum range of motion. And its fourth arm contains the 3D camera that guide the surgeon during the procedure. Now let us understand this with the diagram. The first number in this diagram shows the surgeon console. That means the one who operates the control. And the second number in this diagram shows the image processing equipment The third one, it shows the indoor wrist instrument with the help of which these instrument work. And the fourth number shows the surgical arm card. And the fifth number shows the resolution 3D endoscope. Now, why it is important in the modern treatment? Because in this, the surgeons have enhanced view. There is less required, there is less doctor required in the operating room. There is a smaller risk of infection as well, less anesthesia required, and surgeon tire less easily, and it also is cheaper for the hospital. And here I end my slide. Thank you.
Thank you, Rohit, for wonderfully presented to us today's topic. Now we have Jyoti Ghosh of Hospital Management second semester eagerly waiting to put forward her presentation. Jyoti, over to you.
Thank you, ma'am, and thank you all the faculty members of the Nopan Institute of Management to providing me this field or opportunity to present as a speaker in this webinar. And good afternoon to everyone. So today, my presentation, the topic is robotic surgery, an important concept on modern treatment. So here we go. I shall present my presentation. Thank you. Let me introduce first that what is robot. The term robot was coined by Carol Capek, who was a crazed playwright. The origin coming from the root robota, which means forced labor like the machines that do repeated mental work. Robots have been around for a long time, but only recently have these machines entered the medical field. This change can be attributed to the recent advance in technology that have led to more reliability and therefore wider acceptance by the general populace and the medical community. Next comes the robotic surgical system. So in this system, there are few systems which has been derived, which is first one, supervisory controlled system. So in this, it is the automated type of surgical, which is mostly the automated one, robot, not fully automated. Lot of surgeon involved, pre-work must be done before the robots can perform. This system follows an extremely detailed set of instruction which depend on input from the surgeon. These types of surgeries are common in hip and knee replacement. Then after comes the telesurgical. In this system, are better known as remote surgical system, the surgeon is at a console manipulating the arms of the robot in real time. While technically the procedure is performed by the robot, the surgeon is controlling its movement throughout the procedure. Next come shared control system. The surgeon is involved the most. The surgeons perform the procedure with the help of a robot as an assistant to offer steady manipulation of the instrument. Shared control system are often used in neurosurgery and orthopedic surgery. So next come some recent advancement, which is first one is building blocks. The feature of this robot is the robotic arm that holds a voice activate endoscope, which allows for greater control on behalf of the surgeon in terms of camera positioning. Robot arms was later incorporated into GS. Then comes the Da Vinci surgical system. Da Vinci surgical system is a telesurgical robotic device manufactured by Intuitive Surgical and is one of the most well-known and most widely used robotic surgical devices in the world. Then comes CyberKnife, is a radiosurgical robotic system falling under the category of shared control. Next, what are the benefits and the risk of this robotic surgery? So first one is minimally invasive, which is surgeon don't need to use their hands to directly access the body. If surgeon is not in a state of mind to operate that point of time. So in behalf of the surgeons, the robot do the work. or the operations. It also reduces the time. Recovery is more quick. That's why it reduces the time and will take less time to recover the patient's body. Effective, the less pain and blood loss after the surgery, no dependency on painkiller during recovery. Then advanced technology. The advanced technology, why? Because it's a 3D technology, and due to this, the surgeons no need to provide much time, and as because it is advanced technology, so in that case, in most of the time, many of the surgeries do take places, and it is a curable as well. So in risk as well as disadvantages, you can say, so in that, first of all is malfunction. As new technology and its uses and efficiency have not yet been well established, so in this case, the doctor or the surgeon should be well trained to operate the, to assemble the robot surgeries, the robotic machine. The surgeon should be more than 20 times practiced on this so that they can perform the surgeries. Then comes, it is expensive. Yes, it is a cost. It costs $1 million. Cost is nearly prohibited. Improvement in technology such as haptics, increased processor speed, and more complex and capable software will increase the cost. Size also do matter. Why? Because this system have relatively light footprints and relatively cumbersome robotic arms. Important disadvantage in today's crowded operating rooms as well. And yes, some temporary injuries, which is local injuries, may occur due to exposure to the robot, which might otherwise not occur using traditional tools and techniques. Then comes future of robotic surgery. In today's life, yes, of course, the future, in future also, the robot surgeries will occur, it will be advanced, and it will be related to each and every hospitals as well. So the innovative nature of this new robot was enough to earn it is a game changer award in 2015 from Robotic Business Review. It's thrilling to think where this tech can carry us in the future and how it could make difference in the lives of so many suffering from colon related conditions. It appears that the future has arrived through human surgery still have a role to play in everything from expertise to bedside manner. Robotic surgical tools are constantly emerging to help them to do their jobs. This is the end of the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Jyoti, for sharing your views with us. Now, as we come to the end of today's session, I would like to call Obkumitra Chakraborty from Hospital Management second semester to draw the concluding remarks. Obkumitra, please carry on.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Good afternoon to everyone present here. I, Obkumitra Chakraborty of BBA Hospital Management second semester, am here to conclude the topic, Robotic Surgery, an Important Concept of Modern Treatment. First of all, I would like to thank all the teachers to give me this opportunity to present in front of you all. As rightly said by Jyoti, robots have been around for a long time, but only recently have these machines entered the medical field. Robotic surgery and systems offer precise, accurate, and replicated results that can greatly assist surgeons and improve patient outcomes. The three types had been explained by her very beautifully. Moving on to what Rohit presented. Robotic surgery is a true benefit over conventional therapy and is an advancing surgical technology. Although in its infancy, robotic surgery has proven value in areas of inaccessible conventional laparoscopic procedures. Feasibility has also largely been shown. More prospective randomized trials evaluating efficacy and safety must be undertaken. With this, I would like to conclude. And lastly, thank you for participating and attending this webinar so patiently. You people make a lovely audience. Thank you.
Thank you, Obkumitra. Thank you for your wonderful conclusion.